My name's Adrian Richards. I'm a plastic and cosmetic surgeon. And today I'm going to be talking a little bit about the recovery from a mastopexy or breast uplift procedure. So during a consultation with the surgeon, who may be me, we'll have talked a little bit about the type of mastopexy that was going to be done. I've talked about types of scarring in separate videos. So you should be really quite clear about the likely scarring or techniques going to be used. Okay, so approximately a week before the operation, one of our nurses will be in contact with you to go over a sort of health questionnaire, make sure you're fit and healthy for the operation. And sometimes they may, if you've got a sort of pre-existing medical condition, they may actually call you in to do heart tracings and blood tests just to make sure that you know, the operation is safe as possible for you. We'll also ring you around that time, although you'll know the date of the operation. We like to sort of fine-tune it and bring you in, you know, so you know, 2 to 3 hours really before the operation. So if you're going to be operating first thing in the morning, we often may bring you in the night before, or just say if you're coming first thing in the morning. If it's slightly later in the day, we'll bring you in later in the morning, so you don't have to be in first thing. We'll also give you instructions on fasting. As you know, it's important to have an empty stomach when you have the operation, and as food takes longer to go through the stomach, we like you not to have had anything to eat for 6 hours before the operation. Fluid-wise, we like that to be at least 2 hours for clear fluids. So water and clear fluids go through the stomach much faster than non-clear fluids. So cloudy fluids, any orange juice with speckles in it, anything that isn't absolutely clear, you can't drink for 6 hours before the operation. But clear fluid, you can a little bit nearer. But we'll go through that with you. Important, in the week before the operation, we'd like you to refrain from using some medications, and these include any non-steroidal medications like aspirin, Nurofen, Voltarol, because they thin the blood and they can increase the risk of bleeding. So please stop those for at least a week before surgery. If you're a smoker, it's very important to stop smoking 2 weeks before the operation, as smoking can interfere with the blood supply to the skin and delay healing. Okay. There are some homeopathic tablets which we also don't like you to take, because again, these can thin the blood, increase the risk of bleeding during the operation, and these include St. John's wort, ginkgo, and vitamin E. Okay. Homeopathic arnica is fine, but don't take any non-homeopathic arnica in that time. Okay. So the other point when you come in, a bit of preparation, is please don't use any body ointment all over the breast area, body area, because this interferes with our antiseptic lotions we put on. Also, if you could just keep off the nail polish, because we do monitor your blood saturation through your nails, so no nail polish, or else you'll have to remove it. And another tip is just, if you don't want to wear those horrible hospital baggy pants, you know, just bring in some cotton underwear. If anything synthetic, nylon, or any synthetic substances, it can interfere with some of our diathermy machinery, so we would have to remove it. So the cotton underwear is fine. Okay, so you come into hospital, you'll be met at reception by one of the staff, who will bring you to your room and introduce you to your nurse. Your nurse will then go through, do your blood pressure, ask you questions about your general health, and do your observations, your temperature, pulse, all those sorts of tests. Then you'll see either myself or my anaesthetist. I've worked with my anaesthetist for a number of years, and we've got a very close working relationship, which I think has been very beneficial to get the best possible care when we, you know, work very closely as a team. So you'll see me, I'll draw on you, take photographs if you haven't done them, you know, and when I'm drawing, I'm marking exactly what the plan is. Very important to do the marking with you standing up, because that's, you know, when you get the gravity effects on the breast, and obviously you're going to be lying down in the operation. Although we do sit you up, it's best to do the markings with you sitting up in vertical. Then you'll see my anaesthetist, who will go through what her plan for the operation, and often she'll discuss a technique called an interpleural block, where she'll numb the whole chest up by two small injections in the side, and that will reduce your pain in the post-operative period and make it much more comfortable for you. We'll also give you a small pre-med, which is a tablet to relax you, and normally put some numbing cream on the back of your hand. So then you go down to the operation, you have a small cannula placed in the skin that's already been numb, so you shouldn't really feel that, and then you drift slowly off to sleep. The operation takes about 2 hours, but you'll wake up. You'd probably be aware, first about 3 hours afterwards, probably in recovery, which is the ward we keep you in after the operation. Dressings wise, all you'll have is brown tape on the scars and a surgical bra. We don't use big bulky dressings anymore. So really just a bra dressing. And we may use a drain. Some, about 50% of cases we use a drain, 50% we don't. That will be explained to you before the operation. Okay, so then you'll go back to the ward, you should be completely pain-free, you shouldn't feel sick. Feeling sick after an operation is really rare now. With modern anaesthetics, you really shouldn't feel nauseous at all. And you should feel comfortable, shouldn't feel in pain. And mastopexy is uncomfortable, but it's not really that painful an operation. Okay, so normally we'd like you to rest that day. The following day, if you've got a drain, we'll remove that, the nurses will remove that. But we'd like you to get up and mobile. We will have calf stimulators on your legs overnight, and you'll be massaging the calves to make sure the blood supply is maintained and you don't get reduce the risk of any blood clots. And then we'd like you to get up and about the next day, and you can either go home that night or the night after. This is all within a package, so it's the same cost whether you go home the day after or the day after that. So if you came in on a Monday, you could either go home on the Tuesday night or the Wednesday. And it's not like a hotel, it's got checking out time. You know, we'll make sure that everything's fine and you go home. And you'd be given an appointment to see us a week later. So that's a week following your operation. Now, in that week, if you're at all worried at home, all you need to do is pick up the phone and we'll be there to answer any queries. It's important to refrain from any sort of strenuous activities, anything that causes your blood pressure to go up during that time. So any bending down, housework is out for that week. We don't like driving for that week. You need to give your body the best chance to heal during that week. Then we'll see you in a week in our dressings clinic. The nurses will take off the tape. It's brown micropore tape we take off. And then all the stitches used are absorbable, but the ends just need trimming. So the stitches don't need removing, the ends just need trimming, and then we'll reapply the micropore tape and the bra, because we like to keep the scar supported for 6 weeks following the operation with micropore, as that gives you the best scar in the long term. Just a little tip about bras. You know, it's good to go to the Marks and Spencer or a bra manufacturer and get a bra to change into that 1 week period. And one we normally recommend is the Marks and Spencer Total Support Bra. Get a couple of them, normally CD cups, with pretty much the same. If you were 34 before, get a 34 afterwards, and 36. Get a variety, keep the labels on, and then we can see which one fits you best and you can return the other ones. Okay? But the important thing about your bra, probably shouldn't be a sports bra, because a sports bra tends to compress. We just want gentle support, and it's important. We don't want, everything must be quite elastic, almost like a maternity bra is good, because it will support you without constricting you and keep you comfy. Then we normally see you at second week, and then we like to see you always 6 weeks following the operation, and that's the time we take your post-operative photographs, and we can give you the before and after photographs, a copy of those if you'd like. At that stage. Then the scars will be slightly red, raised at that stage. The scars do go through a red phase, red and raised. After the 6 weeks, we like you to massage bio oil, that's B-I-O hyphen oil, which is a scar oil, into the scars in an effort to sort of encourage them to soften and fade more quickly. And then the scars will normally fade over the months following surgery. So by a year following surgery, they've gone to a silvery colour. But again, if you're worried about any of these topics during your recovery, all you need to do is get on the phone to us, and we'll arrange for you to be seen by either our nurses or surgeon. So I hope that's clarified some aspects about the recovery from mastopexy, which also, sorry, abdominoplasty, which is from the operation.